Hello everyone, welcome to MediaPoon. I'm Jenny. In this video essay, I'm going to compare and analyze two of my videos in this semester, Media Geek and Media Culture. Because the date I upload and promote these two videos are very close, the proportion of audience engagement are different. Media Geek has got a better user's engagement than Media Culture video. This video essay will draw on Berger's framework of characteristic of Knigge's media content in 2013. It relates to six key principles of what causing things to be told, shared, and imitated. According to Nen and Hamsley's pattern of viral video, I will show the life circle of my two videos and discuss the influence of promotion on the videos through Granovetter's argument about strong and weak ties of relationship between people. My Media Geek video is an instructional video. In the video, I focus on two parts. First is the definition of immersion in the video game. Then, I introduce Mirror and Army's SCI model, which divided into three kinds: sensory immersion, challenge-based immersion, and imaginative immersion. The title of this video is Why the Game Time Passes So Quickly. It is a question and the audience needs to find the answer through the video. From the title and video content, it is relating to the fifth principle of Berger's step framework, practical value. It will help them to learn why they think the game time will quicker than it's supposed to be. And the cover of the video is a girl who is enjoying the video. There is a dialogue next to her, is asking whether to begin a game time, and the mouse moves to the yes. It shows people cannot help to spend their time in the game. The cover is interesting, easily attractive, and implies the video title. In order to increase audience interest, I used the pen casting combined with picture and word to express the theory. It is really interesting, and it's good to share on the social media to show their intelligence to arrange their game time. This can be seen as social currency, which is the first principle of Berger's framework. In the video, I design a little story of the specific performance when people are immersive in the video game. It will trigger audience about their experience when we play the video game. The video has four call of actions. Firstly, it asks the audience to like the video. If the video gets more like, it might be promoted by the YouTube on the homepage. Secondly, it asks the audience to leave a comment. It will help the later viewers to decide whether to watch this video, and some suggestions from the video comments will also help producer to improve his video in the future. Thirdly, it asks the audience to subscribe the channel. This has a commercial goal of increasing the likelihood of greater users' engagement in the future. Fourthly, it asks them to share with their friends. As Berger has written that people will not share a new story or recommendation with everyone they know. They tend to select particular people they think would find the given piece of information most relative. Because the target audience of this video are gamers and the student who studies about game, the viewer will share the video with their friend who are also interested in the game. And it will increase the viewer of the video and help the video to find broader audience. As more people share video with their friend and post it on their social media homepage, it will be a viral video. As Nan and Hamsley argued that virality is a social information flow progress where many people simultaneously forward a specific information item. Over a short period of time, within their social network, and where the messages spread beyond their own social network to different, often distant network, resulting in a sharp acceleration in the number of people who are exposed to the message. The life cycle in this video might a little bit different from now and Hanselim's slow fast slow speed of spirit pattern. In the day it uploaded on YouTube, the viewer has achieved the peak, thanks to the viewer who had already subscribed MediaPoon channel, and the decline phase began in the following days. Join on the Granovetter series. I promote my video on WeChat and Twitter on 3rd January 2008, because most of my friends use WeChat as their daily social network, and Twitter is a large platform for people to share content. I could invite strangers to watch my video. It is a weak time on the social network. It will also find from the left circle that the line decreased slowly on the 3rd January 2008. And then, it shows one revival in the 7th. It might because I retweeted the video in Twitter on 7th January 2008. The video finally achieved 6 likes, 4 shares and 3 users' comments. The percentage of audience engagement is 10%. Through the analyze from YouTube, the majority viewers are from the UK, and it also gets viewers from Singapore and German. The age of viewers are mostly from 18 to 34 years old. There are 53% of players aged between 18 to 49. And the proportion of female players increased to 41 in 2006. It seems I reached the main target audience of my video. However, to my surprise, there are 89.7% viewers of my video is female. Although this video was only have 3 comments, all of them are positive. Like this comment indicates the viewers can learn some knowledge from my video. To conclude this section, within the time available, the video which generates good users' engagement in terms of viewers, likes, and shares was MediaGeek, which most demonstrates the contagious character of practical value, trigger, story, and social currency. On contrast, my media culture video promotes a lower level of users' engagement. It is a brief introduction of Beijing Opera. From the title and cover, it will easily to know the theme of the video. And this video is also related to practical value principle in Berger's framework. In the video, I divided it into 3 parts. Each of the parts has a brief subtitle. Stage setting, character, and performance. There is an interview at the end of the video. It will let people know others' opinions of the most interesting parts of Beijing Opera. It will followed by the public principle of Berger's framework. The target audience of this video is limited to those who are interested in opera or the culture of China. The left circle in the video was also achieved a peak at that day when video uploaded. It might because I promoted it to my WeChat and Twitter at that day. The decaying phase happened in the following day. As I retweeted it in 7th, it increased to 9 view and then decaying to 0 view. The video finally achieved 101 views, 2 shares, 5 likes and 1 comment. The engagement of the audience is 7%. Through the analyze from YouTube, the majority viewers are from the UK, and it also gained audience from the US and Hong Kong. The largest age group of the viewers is the young adults from 18 to 24 years old, and most of them are females. To conclude this section, with the time available, the video which generates the lower users' engagement in terms of view, like, share, and comment was media culture, which mostly demonstrates the contagious characteristic of practical value and public, and has a limited target audience. To sum up, I have analyzed the contagious content of my media geek and media culture video through Berger's STEAM framework. Then, I have concluded the user's engagement and the life cycle of the 2 videos. Although the distribution and promotion time of the 2 videos are very close, the proportion of users' engagement in media cultural video is less than media geek. I think the main reason is the media cultural video has a limited audience. Thus, in my future video, I will concern on extend my target audience at first in order to include more viewers. That is all of me for now. If you like this video, please click a like, subscribe our channel, or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.